I was for like five times he said Oni-san. I thought he was talking about the player.
Right.
The
yeah,
Able
yeah.
player. Uh-huh, I was like, yeah, uh-huh. Oni-san. All right, I got you. I was like, yeah, Oni-san of Able. I got you.
Well, you know, if he's taking his shirt off against POONGKO, maybe yeah, he has the ability to buff Blanca, you
exactly,
know?
Yeah.
I mean, there's definitely...
My mind was racing. I was trying to figure it out. I was like, all right, you know.
Like, where's he going with this?
Yeah, I was
where's
like,
he going?
You know, Yipes, is he's all
bars,
over the place.
You know?
Yeah, yeah. He's dropping bars. I'm like, all right, Yipes, you know, you're right. I'm going to let you speak whatever you want to say. Oh, it seems like the winner of this match will play up against Flash. And then later on down there, we have Filipino Champ playing as well in these pools.
Yeah, another, again, a Filipino Champ, you know, he's in a weird position. I mean, we'll talk about it more when we get to him, actually. So I'll save that for a little bit later, because right now we've got POONGKO versus RIVARSAL. And POONGKO going with that Colleen, a character who is really kind of jumped up there in regards for a lot of the players. In fact, we saw Neon yesterday put Momochi into loser's bracket in a Colleen mirror.
Yeah, Momochi's been playing Colleen lately, and Neon, very strong. He's been with that character for a while now, so when the buffs come, it just helps out, you know, even better than usual.
Yeah, Red Bull Battlegrounds last year, both Neon and Nephew did really well with Colleen, and then Nephew has been on a tear at the start of this year as well. Definitely one of those up-and-coming players to look out for this year at the CPT.
Ooh, look for that V-skill. A little out of range, but I like it. I like the try from POONGKO.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think Colleen, very strong this season. She has some great counter pokes. She has some of the best, like, walk back and check your poke buttons that you can ask for. And she has unique and kind of unusual movement that a lot of people struggle to deal with. Vanity step is just, it comes at you at weird angles a lot of time. It's hard to deal. Yeah, stuff like that. A lot of the times it's tough to be prepared, whether it's grounded or the heavy kick vanity that comes from the air.
Yeah, but RIVARSAL was ready for it. He had the anti-air all ready to go. And here we go. I mean, we've always described Infiltration's playstyle as being on ice skates. Well, we literally have ice skates now here with Colleen V Trigger 2.
Yeah, her movement is very strong. And walk back fierce.
Yeah, and she gets a little bit of that extension off of the V Trigger 2 with her punch buttons as well.
V scale very far. Yeah, I get the punish still with standing medium kick. Counter. Look at this new combos, right? Very, very powerful for Colleen.
Right into the critical art is going to take it. And you know, POONGKO was really, really good at spacing out that V skill. You saw him whiff it a little bit too far away earlier, but that's what he likes to go for at that range. However, they did nerf it a little bit. Doesn't push back as far, so even if you block it at max range, definitely punishable for certain characters. And RIVARSAL had the punish, but then just got hit right away.
Oh! The counter, and that's one thing. POONGKO is good at gambling, right? If there's one thing that he is super, super good at, it's taking those kind of risks. Crush counter sweep, takes the side switch.
Beautiful. Very smart. Gets another crush counter sweep. Going for a couple of those sweeps. That's always dangerous. Wow. And POONGKO didn't quite get the punish. I like the idea of the V reversal. Wasn't expecting it to hit, but just wanted to keep POONGKO from getting any momentum off of the V trigger cancel. And now might as well keep spending that bar for V reversals.
Exhale, gets that tick throw off of him. And out of V trigger 2 now. This is a 2-bar, so potential to build another one is there. EX vanity backwards and got the fierce after.
Air to air. Oh, that was beautiful. I love it. Hit him out of the air and went straight for the overhead off of the V trigger.
There it is. Closed it out with a clean CA confirm.
Actually, that wasn't even off the V trigger. That was just a raw overhead.
Yeah,
right,
I think it was
there.
Just like raw resent on it.
Yeah.
Just like did it when he was landing to catch him. This is an unusual move for Karen players to do.
Right, especially because when it's not in V-Trigger, it's punishable. In V-Trigger, it's actually safe. So that's why I was thinking it was in V-Trigger.
Punish, EX Parabellum. We'll see what he takes here. Maybe just a knockdown, yeah, another one.
Small damage, but gets the corner carry with that. Here we go, lockdown.
I thought that was going to be a counter.
Yeah.
She is so strong at blowing up V-Reversal with that option.
Probably was already hitting a button, unfortunately, for POONGKO, and now gets caught. And RIVARSAL getting out of the corner again as well.
POONGKO just waiting. Yeah, activation off low medium kick. Nice part about this trigger is it doesn't shoot out the ice, so you don't lose your pressure and positioning after you activate.
A lot of characters have that benefit now. Rashid is another one of those characters that gets that now. Never had it before. Look at this little pressure right now from POONGKO. Although he didn't get much damage, he did get the corner position, but then RIVARSAL just getting right out of there. And RIVARSAL has that critical R. One hit is could spell death. Oh boy. Oh, he drops.
That was a huge drop on the EX or on the Tenko there at the end. POONGKO with the punish, and yeah, you can see that he is feeling it.
Yeah,
that
was you didn't like, they just cut a little slow because he had full face palm as soon as he dropped that combo.
Yeah.
The hands was covering the face. He was leaning all the way down.
That was you could see that he was feeling it. That's
yeah.
for sure.
But again, that's the execution mistake you make when you're nervous and when you're playing against someone like POONGKO. You're like, oh, I hit him. This is the one for the win.
Yeah,
and that's
in the corner, full bar.
Yeah,
and you're like, yeah, this is gonna be great. And you know.
And then you drop that one, which is why no matter who you play, you just gotta pretend that they're just any other schmuck that you've been playing all day long.
Any old schmuck.
Exactly. Using the that modern language right here.
That's a good word. You can never go wrong with schmuck. Ooh, runs up there. Yeah, that extra movement from the, look at it. And he was prepared this time. POONGKO has done a lot of running up in his face, and that was good recognition from Reversal to have the button. There's got to be a parry sooner or later on those
VR
reversals. POONGKO has got to get wise to it.
Something he's definitely been using a lot of, and now POONGKO down in life, but starting the comeback, goes for the tick throw off of the ice skates.
And he wins here with one hit. He's got great damage added up, two icicles. There hasn't been an interruption on that bait.
Oh, yeah. And the beautiful thing about that bait is no meter needed to spend. And so now he's got all this meter for EX vanity steps or, just any combo extensions.
Just walk back while the sweep after surprised them. And there was a parry counter attempt from POONGKO. Ooh, throw bait mid screen.
Oh, man.
Confirms into the heavy punch parabellum. That knockdown after counter hit.
Yeah, gets with the frame trap, but drops the combo, and that's going to be punished. Okay, POONGKO, feeling a little bad about the other combo drop, so he says, I'll give you one back.
Gave it to him. Yeah, that version does not combo off medium kick. Counter.
Oh.
He was ready for it. He's good at gambling. He knows when to take those reads. Goes low. What a block.
Yeah.
Was that the first uppercut we've seen, too?
I think so, yeah. Unfortunately for POONGKO, he threw out that heavy kick a little too early.
He got in right behind the whiff. Goes low. He's got full CA on deck.
Oh, no. A missed timing just on the meaty.
And he's getting close to being able to chip here. His V-trigger is active.
Right.
If he gets like a Fierce into a Parabellum into a CA, it's getting close. Spends a bar.
Oh, he doesn't even need it. Oh, he had the opportunity right there. One more hit will actually do it. And with patience. And he uses a V-reversal to try to get out of there. That should have been a cancel maybe off the stand light punch, but...
Building a little bit of bar. POONGKO trying to get towards chip. He got him. CA at the end of this. Yeah, that's why he whiffed that low counter just a second ago. Very smart from POONGKO. He's going to be staying on, as we mentioned, to play against in winner's finals of his pool, actually, against Flash.
Yep, Flash, of course, now no longer a Florida player. He is now a Vegas player.